This video is a follow-on from the previous video in the tkinter playlist. Here we're going to have a look at how we can generate a random colour code, a random hexadecimal colour code that can then be used to display colours at random within a Python tkinter graphical user interface. In the previous video, we looked at these hexadecimal codes here that are responsible for setting colours within a Python tkinter graphical user interface. And we have the red, green and blue components. And we start off with this symbol here. Then we put in this position the amount of red we want, the amount of green and the amount of blue. And we ensure that we have a string when we're dealing with the hexadecimal color code. Now this will give us red because this is switching on all of the red. There's no green and there's no blue. Now you need to refer back to the previous video to really get a handle on what the hexadecimal color code is. Here I'm going to show how you can randomly generate a hexadecimal color code and how that color code could then be used to create different colors within the tkinter graphical user interfaces within Python. This is a schematic representation of a list in Python. And if we look at the elements of the list, if we see here, we have got 0, and you can see that in quotes. So what we have in this position is a string of length 1 that contains 0. Here we have another string of length 1 that contains 1. And we can come all the way up to here, and we can see we have another string of length 1 that contains f. Now remember, I'm talking about a string of length 1 because Python doesn't have a character type. Now there are many ways to generate a random hexadecimal code used to generate random colors, but I'm going to do one based upon this list that contains all the characters you would expect to see in a hexadecimal number, from 0 all the way through to 9, and then from A all the way through to F, where A represents 10, B 11, and F 15, and so on. And you need to refer to the number systems playlist on this channel if you're unsure on hexadecimal numbers. And also refer back to the previous video where I covered hexadecimal codes for colours in Python. Now what we need to do is to generate a string for the hexadecimal code that's going to represent the color. And the first symbol we need is this one here. Now this is the hash symbol in British English, and Americans call it the pound symbol. Now, I'm going to stick with the hash symbol because we have a different symbol to represent English pounds, and it's not this one. What we now need to do is, having got this in place, we now need to at random choose one of the elements in the list, and I'm going to show that being this element here. So I'm going to say that F, the character F, the zero length string that contains F, is chosen at random, and we're going to add that, as you can see, to this here, where this is going to be a string that's going to be built up. We'll choose something else at random now, and on this occasion we've chosen the A, and that's now going to be added to this string. And what I've got now is the red component. I'm now going to carry on and choose something else at random from the list, and the one I'm going to choose randomly is the 0, and that's going to come into this string. And then I'm going to choose something else, and this time I'm going to choose D at random, and that's going to come into join the string. And you can see now we've finished the green component of the hexadecimal color code. We will now randomly select another figure from the list, and on this occasion we're choosing the E, so that's added to the string. And now we're going to choose a different character, and that different character is here, which is 2, and that's now going to be added to the string, or a better word, we can say appended to the string, and we'll come back to why we say appended a little later. And there you can see the 2 is appended to the string. And what we have here now is a color code that gives us this color. Let's do this again, and we know we need to start off with this symbol, and we'll choose randomly from this list, and on this occasion I'm going to choose the 0, so that gets appended to the string we're building up. Then I'm going to randomly choose the 3, and that's going to get appended to the string, and I'll do this rather quickly, and you can see we're selecting at random from the list and we're appending to the string as we go along. Here I'm choosing at random the 9, and we're appending that to the string, and then I'm randomly choosing the 2, and we append that to the list. And what we have here now is the color code selected randomly from the list above, and you can see we have the red, the green and the blue as reflected by the colors of the figures. So 03 is the red component, FD is the green component, and 92 is the blue component. Now this color code is going to give us the following color. So we can see that we've generated this code randomly, which gave us this color, and we generated this code randomly, which gave us this color here. Now what I'm going to do now is to move on to a computer program, a Python computer program, that will show us how we can randomly generate these color codes. Here you can see a computer program that will actually generate a color code at random, and we can then use that color code to set the color of the various graphical user interface elements we have when we use tkinter and Python. On this line you can see that I've created a list. Schematically we can show that list as seen here, and you can see it goes from the 0 all the way up to the F. I'd like to return to the previous line, which is this one here. And what this is saying is from random import choice. Now random is a module that contains the necessary code to randomly generate numbers, but it also has this here. Now this is an example of a function that's capable of selecting randomly one of the elements in a list. So I am going to be using this function here to randomly select one of the elements in this list. And we know in this list we have 16 elements going from the 0 all the way up to the F. So when we have this line executing, we have this list created. If we look at this line, what it is going to do is going to create the following variable here, called color code, and of course it's going to have this symbol assigned to it. If we come on to this line, what's going to happen here, we're using this function on this list. So this is going to, at random, choose one of the elements from the list. And for argument's sake, I'm going to say that it's going to choose this one here, the B. So that B is then appended to this variable's content, with the result of that appending assigned to this variable. So the effect is, if we look here, that this variable will have appended to it the B that was just randomly selected, as we can see. We now go on to this line, which is identical to the line we've just seen, but what this will do now, this will randomly choose another element from the list, and I'm going to say that it randomly chooses this one. Consequently, that is now appended. So in effect, we have added to this variable the 0, as you can see. Now this line does more or less the same thing, except on this occasion I'm going to say that this will choose at random 7. And we can see that what this line will then do is append that 7 to this variable, as you can see here. Then of course we go on to this one, which is an identical copy of the line above, and what this will do is choose at random another character, and I'm going to say that it chooses the C, and there you can see the C is going in. If we have a look at this line, on this occasion I'm going to say that that at random chooses the 5, and that 5 will be added to here, as you can see. And then finally we come to this one, and what this is going to do, this is at random, I'm going to suggest, on this occasion selects the 2, and that 2 is appended to what's already in this variable, and you can see here we have a randomly generated color code. Now what this line will do, it'll print out this literal string, and it will then print out the color code. So if we look to the runtime, this is what we will see. There's the literal string being printed, and there is the color code. Now of course I can now use this color code here to set the background of various widgets within my TK Inter graphical user interface. But if you look at the code, it's not the most efficient of programs, because if you look here, you see I've got 6 lines of code that are effectively copies of each other. What I could do, I could replace these 6 lines with an appropriate program structure, with a loop of some kind. So in fact, I could use a loop here instead, as shown by the brackets and the red text that has just appeared. Here's the program I've just discussed, and you can see we're having to import from the random module the code that will allow us to choose randomly from a list. This is the list. This is how we start off setting the color code with the first symbol, and then these 6 lines append to that variable. So we end up with a hexadecimal color code, and this simply prints out the color code that was generated by this program. Now I'm going to alter the code in the following way. Here you can see that if I have a look at these 3 lines in the new program I wrote, they're identical to these 3. If you look at these here, however, you can see there are 6 identical lines, and I've used the line once here. But I've put this line inside a loop, where the loop is a for loop, and it's saying for I in the range 0 to 6, which means that this loop will arrange for this to be executed 6 times, one after another. It'll go round the loop 6 times. So this is effectively the same as having these 6 lines of code here. It performs the same task. And every time you go round the loop, you will choose from the list, you will append to the color code, and the color code grows in size until it has all the necessary hexadecimal characters assigned to the variable as shown here. And this is a typical program statement that you will see used many times throughout your coding experience. And of course on this line, well, I'm simply repeating what I had here. We print out the literal string and the color code. So these 2 programs perform the task, and what I have done, I've removed these 6 lines, and I have instead here the loop, the for loop, which has the effect of executing this line of code 6 times. Now here's the program we've just discussed, and it's the program in which I actually put this line inside a loop so it would execute 6 times. But of course what I really want to do now is to produce a function that will generate the color code for me. And I'm going to show that on the following listing. And if you have a look at this listing, what you can see is I still have this import statement here, and now I've introduced a function. And if you look to the heading of the function, you can see it's got def, and I've chose the name random_color_code. If you look at these 2 lines here, they are the 2 lines that appeared here in the previous program. This creates the list, this starts the color code off with the appropriate hash symbol, and here you can see that I have got this, and what this does here is allows this to execute 6 times, thus building up the hexadecimal code each time it goes round the loop. And of course when I have finished executing this loop, what I have to arrange for is the color code that was set finally when we went through the loop the last time, and we have to return it, as you can see on this line. So we're returning the color code. So this function here will generate the color code for us, the hexadecimal color code. Now what this line does, it's not part of the function, and you can see it is almost the same line as this one here. The difference is, if you look at this line, you can see that we have in this position the color code, which is this variable here, after we've been round this loop 6 times. Whereas if we come to this line, what you can see in this position is a call to this function, because here you can see it says random_color_code, and then it has these 2 brackets. So this is a call to this function. So this will result in causing this to execute. And the output from this program is, as you would expect, will be the color code that was generated. So just remind yourselves, this is needed so we could use the choice function. This is the function. This creates the list. This starts the string variable up appropriately with the first symbol. We go round this 6 times, building up the colour code, and then we return the colour code. And this line prints this string. This causes this to execute. This returns the colour code effectively to this position. So what will be printed out will be the randomly generated colour code. So the runtime for this will look as you can see here. There's the hexadecimal colour code generated is, and this is the colour code that appears in this position because this is a call to the function here that generated the colour code. Consequently, we return the colour code that effectively got returned to this position. That's why it printed out here. So every time you wish to generate a random colour, you generate a random colour code, a random hexadecimal colour code, you would need to use this function here. Now, of course, you can type this function into your code, but you'd be far better putting this in its own module, importing that module, and just then using the function every time you wanted to generate a random colour. Of course, the way I would do it, I would create a class and I would change this function into a method, and I'd put that method in the class, and then I'd create instances and I would put in a number of methods that was responsible for generating colours, drawing lines, drawing shapes, and so on. And this function can easily become a method when you put it in the class. You just have to remember you stick in the gap here inside these brackets the word self, and it will then become a member of the class, and instances of that class can then use that method. So methods and functions are pretty similar. It's just that when you move over to the object oriented world, you have to remember to use self. Whereas here, I'm just showing you as a function. Now, I am not saying that this is the most efficient way of generating random numbers. What I am saying, it is an effective way. And I think it's useful to use it in the way in which I've shown it, because it shows you how lists can be used, how you can randomly select from a list, and how you can build up a colour code that then can be used in your graphical user interfaces to set various colours randomly. In the next video in the playlist, I'll use this function here so you can see a use for generating random colours. So when I go on to the next video, I will be working on the assumption that you understand how this bit of code actually functions. Check out the supporting website for these videos. In addition, why not follow me on Twitter as I issue a tweet every time I upload a new video?